Welcome, everyone, to our Anthem stream on IGN. I'm joined today by the female protagonist lead, Sarah Elmaleh. And thank you so much for coming into the studio with us to play a little bit of Anthem.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah, I thought we would start the stream a little bit differently because we're going to focus on the voice acting talents that you've brought to the
That's all I can talk about. Yeah. That's all I can speak to.
And I want to ask you, how do you decide to approach a character like the one you play in Anthem? And as a lead, it's a very important role because you're the voice of the player. So going into it, what were you like, oh, I'm going to tackle it this way or whatever?
Well, this is. I'm glad we started with this while I can, while I'm not playing, so I can think about it because it is big. And so, it's very difficult for me to kind of describe her in a few short keywords or personality traits. Like for me, with a player character, some player characters this isn't true of, but with a BioWare game like this, I feel like my job is to be a connector. So I am there to connect, and that kind of encompasses a lot of different moods, really, because I'm there to connect the player to the environment. I'm making the environment feel real. I'm making the stakes feel real. I'm connecting you to the people. The relationships need to feel real. So it's less about my flair or my flavor and more about being really honest and really authentic and creating kind of like a pathway for the player to feel like they're being advocated for or spoken on behalf of in this world. So it's actually really hard for me, and there's so much... I've done so many lines and had so many moods and reactions that it's like I've been putting dots on like a chart forever, and now maybe I'll play it and step back and be like, oh, it's a smiley face. Like, cool. So I think it's what's nice is that it's a game about playing with your friends. And so that's what the story is about friendship and teamwork. So for me, that kind of mission of being connected, of really focusing on the people that, you know, as a character, who you're fighting for and who you're fighting with. Kind of making that more of just an active objective and less of like a character flavor was kind of what carries me through all these different moods and reactions, like empathy and anger and all this different stuff can be contained in that kind of mission. And actually on the performance capture is a really interesting special context for that too, because I'm there with my other actors, right? The other people and our living dynamic with each other. Most of the time for games and for a lot of the free roaming stuff, I'm in a booth by myself. I don't get to hear anybody. So, but in performance capture, you get to benefit from closing distance with each other. And this, you know, there's a scene with Owen that I love for that was just really alive and really like surprising because we were on the same stage. So for me, I feel like my job is to bring the characters to the player. My job, like you'll notice in cutscenes, I have fewer lines than the other people. Like it's really kind of about the flavor of and the loveliness of like all these characters that you're kind of becoming fond of. So I talk less. My job on set is to be alive and specific and present with these actors so that they have something to give to the player, back to the player.
Yeah.
And in other cases, like I'm bringing the player to them because I'm kind of the only person on set or the only actor on set who plays games and loves BioWare. So I'm kind of translating, bringing the player to them too. So that's kind of, it's more like what I'm doing and less like what I sound like or one kind of mood.
Okay, so you don't necessarily go in with like a philosophy of how you're going to approach the character. It just kind of comes to you.
That's the philosophy. The philosophy for me is like serving the player.
Yeah.
So like I'm serving your access. I'm a means of access to this world and a means of expressing yourself in it. So it's more like that's, I mean, with every player character, that's kind of the thing, although how you go about it. With this one, it was pretty just, it was more close to me, a cool, capable, less goofy, silly me, but more just like me being as honest and authentic and present in all these different contexts as possible so that you feel like you're connecting through me to the game.
What sort of, do you do any warm-ups or practice or anything before you go?
Yeah,
what do you do?
It's so funny because when I was just starting out and I did do a little, Ray and I both actually went to the same conservatory, different semesters or years, but in Britain. And they
in Great Britain.
We went to the British American Drama Academy, which was great. And they taught us, like, you know, really theater-oriented warm-ups for your voice and your body and everything. And I was so, I did it, and I was in it to win it, but I remember it took me a second because I was so pretentious. I was like, ugh, warm-ups, like, just nerdy people who are just being really pretentious about their process do warm-ups. And now, like, certainly for Game VoiceOver, I'm like, no, it's pretentious and ridiculous to not do a warm-up. Like, it's really, it's naive and arrogant to think that you don't need to warm up your body and your instrument. You'll hurt yourself. So, because you're yelling, you know, it's hard. Can be. So I have like a karaoke playlist in my car.
Oh, nice.
And I will do this thing called straw phonation, which is just a fancy word for like literally humming through, like I use a little coffee stirrer straw.
Oh, really?
Don't hate me. I know straws are bad. But yeah, it's a little a little coffee stirrer straw, and you just sort of buzz it like almost like it's a kazoo. And that vibrates back on your vocal cords and kind of gets them resonating and warm. And so it's very, very gentle. You're not like yelling and projecting, but it does get your system kind of warmed up and gooey. And it's really useful. It's actually very effective. And then I'll just sing the songs too, but gently. It's always funny because I do have Rage Against the Machine in that mix, and I have to remember not to actually sing it.
And you have a good musical taste.
Oh, thank you. But yeah, no, I have to like go easy on the rage.